We've finally seen it. Georgia wins the national title, finally beats Alabama after all these years. Amazing. Truly amazing. I did not believe I would see it. I believe that, once again, Darth Saban would win another title. We'd all go on with our lives, like, living under this evil reign of terror. Once again, said we have a new reign of terror. It's Georgia. SEC, SEC is the same. But congratulations to my SEC brethren, the Georgia Bulldogs. Really, I truly mean that. This game looked like Bama would squeak one out, because you watch this game and you see, oh my God, Stetson Bennett is going to be the reason they lose, because Kirby Smart keeps putting him in positions to fail. A funny thing happened in the fourth quarter, though. At some point, Kirby Smart, you know, Georgia got a one-point lead, started running the football. It was conservative, made some smart decisions, and then testing Bama's corners down the sideline. You know, Bama was, like, going for, they were going obvious pass interference. But at the end of the day, they put themselves in a position to win. And Stetson Bennett made the throw of his life down the sideline, big catch in the end zone. And then the defense finished it off, and Georgia wins 33-18. So I've been on YouTube for a decent amount of time since late 2008. There's a handful of you who remember me from back then. Different channel, different mindset back then. I know a lot of Georgia fans over the years. There's Next Kobe. There's Tau. Magnum, how you doing? I'm sure you're going nuts. If I'm missing anybody, I apologize. But Uncle Lou, of course, I know he's losing his mind right now and celebrating. Outside of like some of the Tennessee fans I know and the Alabama fans, like the Georgia fans were the most passionate people I've interacted with on here. It's been Tennessee, Georgia, Alabama, as a large number of fans. And waiting since 1980, some of these guys weren't even alive then. Maybe they were barely alive, but some of them weren't even alive. And to finally get this win, and the way you win it, you got your asses handed to you by this team a month ago, and then you come in here and you play a different game and you win the rematch. It's a dream come true if you're a Georgia fan. Georgia, through all year, looked like the best team. Everyone said they were the best team, and then they got knocked on their ass. It's like, well, okay, if it's going to be Bama, I guess Bama's going to win it again. But just like with Michigan and Ohio State, it's like, I'm not gonna believe it till I see it. Well, we've seen two things this year. Michigan beats Ohio State, and then Georgia just crushes them. And then here we go. Bama goes down to Georgia for the first time since 07. And they don't play that often. Usually when they play, it's in like a big, it's either been, Georgia and Bama have played more in like a playoff game, a national title game, SEC title game. Rarely do they play in the regular season. I hope that changes. They need to play more conference games in the SEC. Hopefully when Oklahoma gets in there, we can throw our weight around and make some changes, you know, spruce up the place a little bit. But in all seriousness, it's just like, I like watching these two teams play. As a college football fan, and to not see it on an annual basis because they're in different divisions and you have the crossover, the permanent crossover games, and it's just, I liked the SEC last year because they just played all conference games. They played, like, I love more SEC football. And there are times where it's like, man, it'd be really cool if Georgia played Alabama this year. But you just don't get to see it as often because of the whole setup. But you got a really, like, despite the double score, the two score win at the end, it was a fantastic finish. I was personally hoping it would come down to a Bama field goal attempt at the end, just for the drama. I think that was the only perfect way to end it. Like, Georgia blocked a kick earlier. It would have been so amazing if that happened again. But if it was a kick for a win, but like, Georgia did not leave any to any chance at all. And so, got their first national title. And you think we're waiting a long time. We've been waiting 21 years. So, they've been waiting a lot longer. And so Georgia had their run from 80, 81, 82, the Herschel Walker era. And now finally, after all this time, they get one. They get a big one. So they get the one. They get the trophy. So celebrating there. And they do it right in Indianapolis, of all places, in the middle of Big Ten country. So I just figured I'd pop in and just give my two cents and talk about like people I knew in the past and people I still know. So all the guys I mentioned, congratulations. I know you guys are, so the guys I mentioned are the most hardcore Georgia fans I know. And I know they are just like, they're not going to sleep tonight, because I wouldn't either if I were in your spot. So with that being said, I'll just cut it short here. Boomer Sooner, congrats again. Still bitter about the Rose Bowl a couple years ago. I will always be bitter to the end about that, but at least you didn't win it that year. But you got it this year, because you're without question the best team in college football, even with Stetson Bennett at quarterback. Still the best team in college football this year. So y'all have a good one, Boomer Sooner, and college football season is officially over.